So when it comes to improving productivity at work, we know that shortcuts, like shortcut key combinations, play a role. Now, what if you could create shortcut keys that work for all applications on your device? So they aren't specific to an application, they're specific to you. So for example, I have the shortcut key Windows and X to automatically add a timestamp in whichever application I'm in. I use it in File Explorer, I use it when I'm on the web, in OneNote, Word, Excel, or Google Sheets. Every time I use Windows X, I get today's timestamp. Also, if there is a specific text, address, or bank account that you keep repeating in different applications, you can create a shortcut text for it. This way, you just type in your abbreviation and it will automatically replace it with your longer text in all applications. It's great for repetitive typing or sending canned email or LinkedIn responses. So what is this based on? It's a free application and is something I've started to use recently, and I hope it's going to benefit you as well. It's called AutoHotKey. It's an open source automation tool for Windows. It can be used to launch applications, run a specific set of tasks, and even create interfaces. Now, its most common use and probably the easiest way to use it is for text expansion, which means creating your own abbreviations to auto-replace lots of text. I'm going to give you a quick overview to help you get started. Remember, it's a free tool, so if this is something that you think can help you, just download it and give it a go. Let's start from the beginning. You can install the AutoHotKey app directly from their website, which is autohotkey.com. Just come here, click on download, and then you can download the current version. Now you can also download this from the Microsoft Store. Just open up the store, type in AutoHotKey, and you should see it pop up here, and then just click on get. Now, after you install it and you go through the steps, you are going to end up on this page. Now, this is actually the help for AutoHotKey. You can find all the documentation here. Now, on the welcome right here, notice that it says before AutoHotKey can do anything, you need to write a script telling it what to do. Basically, create a script, add hotkeys, run the script. So you can go ahead and take your time, read through these and see how it works. Check out all the documentation. In this video, I'm going to do the steps together with you and share with you some of scripts that might come in handy for you. So we are going to do all of this together, which means that we don't need this window. We can close it. After you've installed AutoHotKey, you should be able to right mouse click, for example, on your desktop, go to new and find the AutoHotKey script. That's what we want to create. Now we can give this a name. I'll call mine favorite shortcuts and enter. So it's just important that the extension is AHK. Don't double click it because double clicking it is going to run the script. Basically, it's going to add it to your tray here, meaning that it's active, it's ready for you to use. But we don't have any scripts yet because we haven't added our favorite shortcuts yet. And to do that, we have to right mouse click and open this in Notepad. So now notice I see edit script. I can open it directly like this. If you don't see that option, just open it with the text editor of your choice. You're going to see some lines that are already pre-populated. These are intended to improve the overall script performance. The rest is up to us. We can start typing here. Now there are two main types of scripts. There are hotkeys and hotstrings. So what are hotkeys? Well, to quote the official tutorial, a hotkey is a key that is hot to the touch. Obviously, they're kidding unless you knocked your T over your keyboard. Actually, it's usually a combination of keys on the keyboard that you can press to trigger an action. Basically, they're your own custom shortcuts that can run anywhere in your system. Okay, so let's say the first shortcut that we want to create is to launch an application. In my case, the application I use most, which is Excel. So the way this works is that the first thing you need is the shortcut key combination, and I want to use Control E. The way you specify the Control key is using the caret symbol. This stands for Control. And then you just type in your key, so I want Control E. This is followed by two colons. The two colons separate the hotkey, which is this, from the action that it's going to trigger. Now the action comes below. That action is run, comma, Excel. Because Excel is a Windows application, I don't need to specify the path or the extension. The action is also followed by a comma, to tell it that we are finished with this, we need to put the return statement. This stops the code from going further. Now, before we run this, let's just do a few more so we can run them all together. If you're wondering what the symbol for Windows is, it's the hash sign. So let's say I want to add a fun shortcut for Windows J, and what I want to happen is a message box to appear. The code for that is MSG box, comma, and then you just type in the message that you want. I'll just type this in, why not? And we're going to end with return. Now, just in case you want to use other common hotkey modifier symbols, you can use the exclamation mark for Alt or plus for Shift. You're going to find even more in the official documentation. Okay, so we did two here. Let's do one other one, and this one I find super useful. This is to add the current date. I'm going to assign the shortcut hash X and colon colon. Now, the first step is to define the format. So I'm going to go with format time, comma, I'll just call this XX, and then comma, comma, and define the type of format that I want. So I'll go with YYY, MM, and DD. Then we have to go with send input, comma, and we want this reflected, so percentage sign, and double X, and percentage again. Now you don't have to memorize any of the stuff that I'm doing. You just can copy them, put them somewhere, tweak these a little bit to go in the format that you want, and reuse them. You're going to find a lot of these in the documentation. So for example, if you're wondering where did I get format time from, you'll find it in the documentation. So remember this page, this was our starter homepage. If I go to string, format time, you can find all the different ways and options that you have here with lots of examples. So you can just feel free, copy some of these and add them to your own code. Okay, so now we have three hotkeys. Let's test these out. I'm going to close this. We're definitely going to save. Now to run this, you have to double click it. When you double click, and it's the first time you are running it, you're going to see it pop up here. If you make changes to it and you double click, you're going to get this message that there is an older instance, and if you want to replace that, you're going to go with yes. Okay, so let's test things out. I had the shortcut key Control E for launching Excel. I'm going to try that, Control E, and we should see Excel pop up, and it does. Next was that message box, and I used the Windows and J combination. Why, you're amazing. Next one was Windows X. That was to get the current day. Now for that, let's just go anywhere here. So I'm in Windows Explorer. I'm going to, let's say, create a new folder, and I'll type a name, underscore. Now I'm going to use my shortcut key, Windows X, and I get the current year, month, and day. Okay, so this is a shortcut I can use in any application. Let's take a look at something else, Hotstrings. But before we get into Hotstrings, let me tell you about another tool that's hot on my list. It's not really a tool, it's more like a platform or a community. You get to learn different skills really fast. So this can be in the area of personal improvement, it can be business, or whatever you want to learn out of pure interest. The platform I'm referring to is called Skillshare, who've been kind enough to sponsor this video. What I like about the learning experience there is that you get short, condensed classes. I usually don't have big chunks of time to dedicate to learning, and this way I can use whatever time I have and learn something new really fast. So I was super excited to find one of my favorite YouTubers on Skillshare. So of course I immediately took his class. You probably know him. It's Marquez Brownlee. The class is about how to script, shoot, and edit for YouTube. If you've ever seen a video by him, you're going to appreciate the storytelling and the production quality of his videos. Some great tips there were how to plan the visuals and how to shoot the videos. I have a long way to go in comparison, but yeah, change doesn't have to be one big leap. It can be gradual, right? Everyone goes at their own pace. So it's classes like this that can help you improve your skills. You can get the knowledge that you need to grow a side hustle if that's what you want to do right now, or pivot your career. There are new premium classes launched each week, so there's always something new to discover. And because Skillshare is sponsoring today's video, the first 1,000 people to use the link in my description box below or my code Leila Gharani will get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare. So make sure you check it out. Thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring this video. And let's get back to creating our hot strings. We're going to go back and edit the script. I'm going to right mouse click, edit script. So hot strings are used mainly to auto replace abbreviations as you type them. For example, assume you're writing an email and instead of typing out your entire name, you just want to type LGH. And then when you press space or tab, you want it to convert to your full name. You can use a hot string for that. You just have to define the abbreviation and then you have to define what you want on the other side. Now, the way AutoHotKey knows that this is a hot string is with this syntax. So you have a double colon before and we keep that double colon after, and then you have your hot string. Now check this out. I'm going to close this, save it, and then run it. So don't forget to double click and run it. Now let's assume I'm typing an email and I want to put in my name. I'm going to type in LGH space and then I'm going to get my full name. Now you can imagine the possibilities here. You could, for example, create a hot string for your email address. I'm going to go with the @. I'm just going to use a double @ and then type in my email address. This way, every time I want to log into different applications, I don't have to type my entire email address out. I can just use this hot string, the double @. You could use it for symbols, right? So if you, for example, use some special symbols that you constantly find yourself copying and pasting, you could create a hotkey for that. So let's say I want the copyright symbol. I'm just going to paste it in here and I could use this hot string to get the symbol. I don't have to go and find the keyboard shortcut for it or copy it from another application. Now, if you use a lot of code windows, so let's say you're a programmer, you're typing a lot of code, and then you want to type some comments or some description inside your code box, and you don't have a spell check in that application. You could put some of the common words that you misspell in here. This way, it's going to auto-correct them as you're typing in your code window. So for example, maintenance, if that's a word that you use often, you could type the correct versions here. Okay, you just have to be careful that you don't use words that you actually want typed out in the original way. Another great use case for this is to create template responses. So I'm going to call this TFQ. So let's say thanks for your query and then paste in this response. So let's say this is something that I usually need to type out or I need to copy and paste it from somewhere else. If I create a hot string for it, I have it available in my Outlook. I can use it over on LinkedIn or in any app that I'm in. Now remember, for this one here where we defined the year, month, and day, we defined a hot key for it, but we could also define a hot string. So I'm just going to copy this, paste it here. And for the hot string, I'm going to go with LG review and then colon, colon. Now let's say I don't just want to put in this, but I also want to put in reviewed by Leila. Now, in addition to this, I want to add the time. For that, we're going to use a similar format. So it's format time. Instead, I'm going to define another variable ZZ. And this time I want the time in hour, minute. So minute is with small m, month is with capital M, and then SS for seconds, and TT for AM and PM. Now I want it in my final output, so I'm going to follow this by percentage ZZ and percentage, right? So it's easy to pick up the pattern on how you can update these, and to find the formats that you need, you just have to review the documentation. Okay, so these are our different ones. Let's go ahead and test some of these. I'm going to close, save, let's say double click to run this. Now I'm going to bring up my email here and use my hot string. That was TFQ space, and I get my template response. This is on two separate lines because I had enter inside the script. It was surrounded by curly brackets. Now, what else can we try? Let's go with copyright. I think that was like that. When I press space, I get the copyright symbol. And if I type LG review and space, I get that timestamp here, which includes the hour, minute, seconds, and AM or PM, and the text that I want it to have. Now, if we are in a code editor, so here I'm in the VBA editor, and let's say I'm typing a comment and I put maintenance, it auto corrects it to maintenance. I put LGH and I get Leila Gharani, copy R and I get the copyright symbol. If I want to log into my accounts and I need to type my email, I can use my hotkey @@ and then I get my email address. Okay, so AutoHotKey scripts can get more complicated than what we covered today. They can contain evaluations and loops, they can have custom functions and subroutines. But I hope that this short introduction already gave you an idea on how you can make your work a bit more efficient and save time. So if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and consider subscribing if you aren't subscribed yet. Thank you for watching, and I'm gonna see you in the next video.